There's a story of some children who are in one of the old schools run by nuns, presumably. And they get, and it's lunchtime, and they all line up at the tables, and there's a nice big bowl of apples, and there's a sign that says, "Take only one. God is watching." They work their way through, they get their plate, and there's at the end there's some biscuits. And some kid's written a sign, "Take as many as you want, God's watching the apples." I love that story. Let's see if I can make it somehow connect to the Old Testament lesson today. I'll think of something. Because I wanted to look at the Old Testament lesson, and there's a couple of really interesting moments in there. The first, and this is what made me think of the story, is God is saying, "I have heard the Israelite people in Egypt as slaves. They're crying out." And I thought, isn't that a fascinating thing? When we're in trouble, we're very happy to cry out to God, aren't we? It's like, "God, help! I'm in trouble. I've done some foolish stuff, and I would really like some assistance here." But when things are going okay, or when we're perhaps doing maybe, we sneak in a couple of extra biscuits, and there are natural consequences for keeping sneaking a couple of extra biscuits, aren't there? We wear those, don't we? We don't want God watching. We want God to have sort of selective blindness. It's an interesting thing, isn't it? In the Old Testament, particularly, when God sees, it means something is going to change. Do we want God seeing a lot of what we do? I think quite often we'd be happy for the answer to that to be no. You know, we might, maybe we don't act with the kind of love and generosity we should. Do you want God seeing that? I don't. There's a lot of things I hope God's not paying attention to. And so there's a challenge there for us. The next thing that I noticed is this. A while ago there was an animated movie called The Prince of Egypt. And it's sort of an attempt to tell the story faithfully but not slavishly of Moses and the escape of the people from Egypt. So it tells the story, but it also tells it loosely. But there's the scene when Moses comes across the burning bush is really quite interesting, because the voice of God and the size of the flame are associated. So when God says, "I am who I am," the flame is huge. But when he says, "Be here, take off your shoes, your sandals, you're on holy ground," it's this almost this really gentle whisper. The thing with our shoes is we wear them to protect our feet. And sometimes, you know, nice pair of shoes, they look good. But they also separate us from the ground. And our clothes do the same. When human beings first started wearing clothes, it was to protect them from the cold. Clothes have a primary function of protection. Sometimes they protect others from the sight of us walking around without clothing, which would be quite horrifying in some cases. I'll leave you with that mental image. But there's this thing about holiness where we come unprotected to it. We come vulnerable before God. You see, God sees us, even when perhaps we'd rather God wasn't. We'd rather God was paying attention to the apple so we could sneak the extra biscuits. We wish that God was paying attention to the clothes so God doesn't see who we are. But when we're approaching holiness, we come vulnerable. We come spiritually naked. And we become like the bush. You see, the thing about that bush is that it burns, but it's not burned up. The bush is ablaze but not consumed. And what that means is it means that it is a transmitter of the energy that comes from God. I like science and stuff. I don't know if I've ever mentioned that. So a fire, the triangle of fire. Yeah? You've seen this? Fire needs three things. It needs fuel, heat, and oxygen. And what it does is it's an exothermic reaction, which means it gives off heat. That's why we put our hands. It's nice. We put our marshmallows over the fireplace. But the heat consumes the fuel. In this case, it doesn't. Because the fuel doesn't come from the tree. The fuel comes from God. When we are on holy ground, when we have the courage to be vulnerable, to be seen by God as who we are, and we're doing the good stuff and the bad, we have the capacity to be transformed, to be like that bush, to burn, but to be not burned up. I think that's one of the great temptations and the great problems that we often have in our world, is that people, they think God's not watching. And so they try and do it all themselves. And they get burned up. This happens in the church. It's not like this happens out there, not me. None of that. The courage, the challenge, is to be vulnerable, to take off our shoes before a God who sees us naked and cares for us, who wants us to be holy, so that we might be a living example of his words to the world. In the name of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.